Dependency injection is a way to design software so that code, like a function, does not have its dependencies hard-coded into it. Instead, the information that the function needs is given to the function when it's called. There are a number of reasons for this. It decreases the coupling between a function and its dependencies, it can decrease the complexity of that function, and it makes it easy to configure the function if it needs a new or different dependency. This topic can be a little convoluted to work through, though. So I've got some friends to help me explain it. We've got Brittany.
Hi.
Cameron.
Hello.
Kagure.
Hi.
Walter.
Hello.
And Mike.
Hey.
Here's what a typical day looks like in a dependency injection world.
Hey, what's up, Brittany?
Hey, Cameron, what's going on?
Well, I've got a lot of tires. Any kind, any shape, any size.
Great, and where do you sit?
Over there.
Okay, great, thanks.
Cool.
Hey, I just got in and I've got
okay, what do you got for me?
Blue bricks.
Okay, what sizes?
One by ones. I think I have some, I think there's like a 2x2. There may have been like a bridge 4x.
Okay, you have it all. Got it. Where do you sit?
Over there.
Okay, awesome, great, thank you.
You're welcome.
Hi.
Hi.
Reporting for duty.
Okay. What do you have? How much do you have and where do you sit?
Red bricks, a whole bucket full of them, over by the wall, third from the left.
Okay, thank you.
Oh man, another prop for a course.
This email. Hey, Brittany.
Hey, what do you need, babe? Because whatever it is, I got it.
I need to create a prop for an upcoming course. I can do it, but I still need some red bricks, some blue bricks, and some tires. For the blue bricks, I'll need...
I got it. Don't worry. I'll be right there. Okay, blue bricks was red bricks was Walter, tires, camp. Okay. Quick, we need blue bricks. Come on. Let's go. Walter, we need red bricks. Oh, my gosh.
You need tires?
Yes.
All right, let's do it.
Let's go. Oh, okay. Okay, he's got the red bricks. We got wheels right here. We got the other bricks right here. Okay, are we good?
Yeah, we're good.
Okay, thanks, I gotta go back to work.
So that was a fun little skit to make. But dependency injection is an important architectural software pattern, and I want to make sure you understand what's happening. Instead of being in charge of all of the bricks and the tires myself, I just depended on these outside resources to be provided to me. Brittany, the injector in our real-life app, knows where all of the information and services are. Whenever an app needs some service or information, it tells the injector its requirements. Then the injector fetches those requirements and provides them to the calling code. Then the code uses those services to accomplish its task. Dependency injection is heavily used in Angular. We'll make use of it ourselves in the next video on Angular services.